Welcome back to Math 103. This is video number 2 on Growth and Finance. So far we have found that the tuition in 2015, assuming a 4% growth over the tuition in 2014, will be this quantity. The old tuition times 1 plus 0.04, and that equals what it equals, 11,000 and something. To put this expression a little bit more simply, that's $10,954 times 1.04. equals the new tuition. We're going to see expressions like this 1.04 throughout this chapter. It's going to be a very important type of mathematical expression. The key point is that increasing a quantity by 4%, causing it to grow by 4%, is equivalent to multiplying it by 1.04. This is a crucial idea that the entire subject rests upon. A way to think of it is that this factor of 1.04, this number we multiply the original tuition by, gives a one-number summary of the growth that occurs in the 1 year we are investigating. It deserves a special name. It's called a growth factor. We call it a factor because we always multiply by it to find the effect of growing by 4%. So if a quantity grows by a certain percent, whether it's 4% or some other percent, then the new quantity, the results, equals the original quantity times the growth factor. And how much is that specific growth factor? Well, it depends how much the percent is of the percentage growth. So if a quantity grows by, this might seem a little bizarre, 100i%, okay? In other words, when the percentage is converted to decimal form, it equals I, then the growth factor equals 1 plus I. Right, that was probably mysterious. Let me explain. In our example above, tuition grew by 4%. 4% in decimal form equals 0.04. So I here equals 0.04. Right, our growth factor is 1 plus 0.04. Right, so 0.04, that's I, times 100, that's just converting from decimal to percent form. So 0.04 times 100 equals 4%. This 100i here might seem bizarre, but all it has to do with is passing back and forth between decimal terms and percent terms. A common question which students often continue to ask, even after what we just talked about, is where does that 1 in 1.04 come from? Right. What if we just multiplied by 0.04? That would tell us the amount of the increase after 4% growth. It's how many dollars more you will be paying for tuition next year than you are now. But multiplying by 0.04 by itself does not tell you the total new quantity, the total new tuition. To find the total new tuition, you need to account for both the original tuition, hence the 1, as well as the increase, hence the 0.04. Another way of saying this is that the new tuition will be 104% of the original tuition. It'll consist of 100% of the old tuition, because all the old amount is still there, plus an additional 4% of the old tuition. That's the increase. Let's consider some follow-up examples. If in-state tuition increases by 4.25% in 2015, what will the new tuition be? And what is the associated growth factor? So the first thing we need to do is express this percent, 4.25%, in decimal form. 4.25%, or 4.25%, needs to be written in decimal form as 0.0425. Once we have that, we can say that the growth factor, which is really the quantity that comes next in our thought process, the growth factor is 1 plus this percent increase, but expressed in decimal form. In other words, 1.0425. The new tuition will equal the old tuition, the original tuition, times the growth factor. So $10,954 times 1.0425. And that turns out to equal $11,419.55. Now, to get exactly that amount, you have to round to the nearest cent. And that's worth remarking upon here. In these financial examples, you may have reason to carry many more decimal places of accuracy along the way, but at the very end, you should round to the nearest cent. Before going on to the next video, answer the following questions. We continue to work with the data that in-state tuition at Rutgers in the 2014 to 2015 year is $10,954. If in-state tuition increases by only 0.4% in the next year, the 2015-2016 year, what will the new tuition be? And what is the associated growth factor? Another question could be, if in-state tuition increases by only 0.04% in the next year, what will the new tuition be? And what is the associated growth factor? So there's such a thing as 0.4%. Yes, 0.4 is a decimal, but 0.4% is a percent. 0.04%, that's an even smaller percent. But whether the number in front of the percent sign is a whole number or in decimal form, the way that you convert percents to decimals is still the same. Think about that.